guest comes to you unless you invite them. Not only you invite them, you send email, leave voice message and fax, telegram. Even after that, you send somebody to bring him personally. Once he enters your house, you say, "Oh, I never thought you will come. I thought somebody else will come." Same way, you send message to your thoughts. You have a strong faith that death fear is going to come back. When you have the strong fear, when you have the strong idea, when you have a strong desire, the fear is going to come back. You will fulfill your desire by bringing the fear back. Understand, every moment, by your very nature, you are replacing your thoughts. People come to me and they ask me, "Swamiji, I am suffering with too much of sexual thoughts. How can I escape? How can I get rid of it?" I tell them, sit here, 1 hour meditate on sex. Again they open their eyes and say, "Swamiji, mind is not able to stay in one on that same subject. It is going everywhere." Are you only come to me and say, "I'm caught by these thoughts, I'm not able to get rid." If I say concentrate on that, then you say, "I'm not able to." It means what? By your very nature, you are unconnected, independent, illogical, unconnected thoughts. You neither have to worry about your fear, nor have to worry about your greeds. Your worry about your worry, your worry about your fear, your worrying about your greed is the only problem. Your fear is not a problem. Your fear about your fears is the problem. Let it be very clear. Actually, we are not afraid of our failures. We are afraid of our fear of failure. Not even failure. For example, by the end of this year, we know for sure we are not going to become billionaires. Are we worrying about it? Are we suffering? "Oh, I am not going to become a billionaire. What will happen to me? I don't know." Are you suffering? No. You don't bother. You don't suffer because of the failure. But you always suffer. Will I have $100,000 or not? The suffering is because of the possibility. The fear is because of the possibility. Fear is not connected to your failure. Fear is connected to the fear of failure. That is the fear. In every level, if you are haunted by greed or fear, let it be very clear, it is just because of your clutching. Just because of your clutching and connecting. If you understand this one truth, constantly you renounce, constantly you are replacing your own thoughts. Just a glass of water is enough to get rid of death fear. Because the moment you decided to have a glass of water, already the fear of death thought has disappeared from you. If it is so strong, it should be there staying. But it can be just replaced by a single cup of tea. A cup of tea is more than enough. A glass of water is more than enough to get rid of fear of death, to get rid of the great griefs, to get rid of any problem in your life. I can say, because whatever problem, you can have only one thought at a time. Am I right? Can you have two thoughts at a time? No. Only one thought at a time. So be very clear. Your enemy is only one thought. When you start believing in unconscious and subconscious, you make your enemy too powerful. You clutch all the thoughts. The problem is not a single thought of fear. The problem is you thoughts of fear which you had from your birth, and create a shaft and start believing, I am filled with fear. The fear of death which happened in you 10 years ago, the fear of death which happened in you 9 years ago, the fear of death which happened in you 8 years ago, the fear of death which happened in you yesterday, they are all unconnected, independent, illogical, unclutched fears, unclutched thoughts. When you connect all of them and create a shaft, you create a shaft, my life is filled with fear. The moment you created this shaft, you created hell for you. You created hell for you. And you start suffering with it. Be very clear. Do not empower your enemy before fighting with him. You empower your mind and trying to kill him. First thing you need to understand, you cannot kill him because he doesn't exist. If he exists, you can fight with him. But you are fighting with your shadow. You are fighting with darkness. You are fighting with somebody who doesn't exist. In Sanskrit we say Maya. Maya means Yama iti Maya, which does not exist but which gives you the experience as if it exists, is Maya.